Back in 1990, Tim Curry terrified an entire generation with his portrayal of Pennywise the Clown in the TV adaptation of Stephen King's It. Pennywise popped up in places that ought to be safe, like a domestic back garden or a library during the day, to terrorize and torment his victims. And maybe that's why, for so many audiences, It tapped into a fear they never even knew they had, a fear of clowns. Coulrophobia, as it's known, seems to be more commonplace these days. But what is it about clowns, those wacky figures of fun, those jesters and jokers, that inherently unnerve us so much?
Don't you want a balloon?
Much like Pennywise in It, clowns appear, on the face of things, friendly, with their bright, colourful garments, big, smiling faces, and cheery dispositions. And yet, despite all this, there's this strange, overwhelming feeling that something's off, that maybe, as with Pennywise, there's something deeply sinister beneath that gaudy, lurid exterior. But Pennywise wasn't the first clown in cinema to give audiences sleepless nights. In fact, the creepy clown is almost as old as cinema itself. In 1924, Lon Chaney starred in He Who Gets Slapped. Chaney plays a disgraced scientist who, upon losing his career, resorts to circus performing. His nightly act consists of being repeatedly slapped by his fellow clowns for the audience's amusement. As if this clown isn't creepy enough, at the end of the film, Chaney's character is stabbed and killed, and yet he's still smiling. A few years later, that tragic smile was stretched to even greater extremes by actor Konrad Veidt in the German expressionist movie The Man Who Laughs. Veidt plays the tragic hero who is disfigured at a young age and is left with a permanent grin. Despite being a compassionate, sympathetic character, The Man Who Laughs is creepy and is said to have inspired one of cinema's greatest villains, Batman's nemesis, the Joker.
Now I'm always smiling.
Whether intentionally or not, Chaney and Veidt were two of cinema's original creepy clowns. Both had previously starred in horror films and both effortlessly brought a palpable sense of the uncanny to these otherwise sympathetic characters. The uncanny is a concept describing the psychological experience of something strangely familiar, yet somehow out of the ordinary. In an essay published in 1919, Sigmund Freud used the term uncanny when exploring the eeriness of dolls and waxwork models. And it's easy to see why. Who isn't unnerved by the ventriloquist dummy in the portmanteau horror Dead of Night? Or, of course, the clown doll in Toby Hooper's Poltergeist? When we first meet Art the Clown in Damien Leone's Terrifier, he seems the perfect, queasy embodiment of the uncanny. His face appears binary, happy and sad, black and white, no shades of grey and yet impossible to get a read on. Similarly, in It Chapter 1, Richie can't get a read on the clowns that surround him. He's trapped in a room of eerie ambiguity. Are they real or imaginary? Harmless or deadly? The creepy clown, of course, eventually became a movie monster as ubiquitous as the vampire or the werewolf, and filmmakers began pushing that monstrous quality of the clown to increasingly grotesque extremes. But if clowns become too monstrous, do they lose that uncanny quality and cease to be creepy? 80s cult classic Killer Clowns from Outer Space is great fun, but it's not particularly frightening. Equally, on the other end of the spectrum, if clowns are too human, it could also diminish that creep factor.
What's the matter, kid? Don't you like clowns?
In Rob Zombie's The Devil's Rejects, the character of Captain Spaulding wears clown makeup, but it's faded, dirty, less transformative. He doesn't behave with the ambiguity or creeping menace of Pennywise, There's no mystery behind this clown's intentions. He relishes in being an aggressive, murderous psychopath. So, as creepy clowns inevitably continue to evolve towards increasing levels of grotesquerie, perhaps it's important to remember that less is more. The creepiest clowns in cinema live in that strange, uncanny valley between one world and another, comedic and tragic, good and evil, human and monster.
Happy trails.